Hello, me again. You're probably sick of me by now. Here we are on Windchaser again. I'm on our dairy operation. Have our T9 700 with the silage blade. Hopefully, John Deere modding will finish one of his blades so I can use it with side brackets so I don't have to use this silly contraption anymore. So I just finished washing the sprayer and the T8 320. We have the other T8 out mowing our alfalfa, one of our smaller alfalfa fields right now, so I'm just putzing over those fermenting silos or not. Just putzing over to our toy barn over here, and this is the newest little addition. It's a CR1090. A bit unrealistic for our operation. What we really need is like a crone or a jaguar or some kind of forage harvester, which we don't have yet. So I might be trading this off and getting a forage harvester. But the skin itself is courtesy of Big Boss Modding's Raphael. It's like a dark yellow. It's really cool with the all black, blacked out rims and tires. So the only difference is this is an 800 bushel grain bin, which is courtesy of, to be honest, I'm not even sure who made it. I think it's possibly John Deere Modding, maybe 9560R, Justin Hayes, whoever it is, you all know who it is. It's awesome, I like it. So anyways, while we're over here, open up our toy shed here, and actually, it might, I don't remember if I just bought it, or, okay, we need to putz on over to the dealer, my bad. So we'll putz on over to the dealership to pick up our new windrower. We went from a four-wheeled windrower, which was like 12 and a half meters working. So here's the north part of 11 I was talking about, and course play is mowing the south half, south section, so. Finally have the town, probably like 80% done. All fields are now purchasable and whatnot. So we're just gonna open up our gate here. Pick up this awesome machine. It's a little dirty, so we'll go wash it quick. But this thing is just massive. We're milking 700 dairy cows. We have no pigs, we have no beef. We're just using alfalfa for hay and silage, and we're also using corn for silage, we pretty much just chop barley, oat, and wheat for straw. was a fail. This thing's so much bigger. So we got our little tractor sides, we got our posted sides. Sorry if I feel a little groggy. I'm a little bit sick. Been crazy with exams. I'm actually on a study break right now. I'm just really sick of studying. So I have an ortho, if you guys are familiar with braces and stuff, orthodontic. So I have pediatric restoration and pediatric orthodontic clinical exams tomorrow. Nothing really, not a real big deal. It's not like a lecture. It's just clinic where we just do procedures. But that's tomorrow, so I've been kind of like up late studying for that and such. So I'm very interested to see how this turns out. So we're running all New Holland on this in this operation. Some of our grain farm equipment is Case IH and John Deere. We're running, we have dual manure spreaders, and then a large solid manure. So we have like over 80,000 liters of milk right now. So we'll be making a decent amount of money towards midnight. So as you can see, our course play is just going to town on this crazy crazy long field. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run this on manual for a bit. And see what I can do. Obviously going to set up GPS running course. I'm going to load my course 12 so it goes a long way, and I'm going to set the axis. Oh my gosh. Okay, 19.5. That's pretty incredible. Lower this. Oh my gosh, this is massive. So I'm only doing the headlands up on this section because it's really tight and kind of odd angles, and then I'm just gonna do my straight, and then finish with headlands. So it's not like we're crazy farmers over here. All right, so we got that. Just want to make sure I get all of everything I chopped or mowed. So it looks like we got a good line here. I'm just gonna go ahead and, oh shoot, all right. Move this over. To, I'd say right about there. And just hit the pedal to the metal. HUD hider, get this. So, I mean, our fields, our alfalfa fields aren't that big. See, there you can see our LRTA going to town. But we get some pretty decent yield out of them because it's all fertilized. So. So this will be pretty easy to pick up with either a forage harvester or a loader wagon. If you were to bale this, you'd be spitting out bales at like a record pace. So, we pretty much got, we've been doing everything, everything really, like, extreme, except, beef and pig farming. We've done forestry, we've, done crop farming, we're milking 700 cows right now, so we have a pretty large, dairy operation. The only thing we don't have, actually, is a large milk trailer and a large water trailer. And I know they're available, I just haven't taken the time to download them and look them over to make sure they're error-free and function well and look good. But I'm really happy with this this windrower. This thing is amazing. I wish it would make it a little bit tighter, but I think that's a known issue on 4X maps, is when you windrow, it's not perfect. You can see it's kind of, it's like the number blocks themselves are, they like skip or something. So that guy's just flying. I have him doing just 6 loops, and hopefully he'll get most of it, and then I'll go back over there and take control. So I'm using the bale extension, which means you actually have to let this dry. You can see the clip distance, it's a little bit dark, or it's a little bit light. And you'll see it turn dark once it's like had an ample amount of time to dry, but we're covering so much ground so quickly that you'd have to wait a couple hours to bale this. Otherwise the moisture content would be too high and the quantity in your bale would be lower. The only thing with course play is it kind of like misses spots sometimes. That's the only downside. It's not smart enough to avoid obstacles that are in like middle of fields and such. It should really be called course saver or life saver, time saver, something like that. Because if you don't have anyone to help you on multiplayer, it's you can do a lot with it. You can run your overloaders, your grain carts, you can run your semis, you can run your combines. You can pretty much have, you know, like 10 machines going and getting work done, but you have to make sure you make the courses correctly. Otherwise, it's more of a pain than anything. So there goes the train, the grain train. So I remember a couple years ago when I was back in the Midwest, I'm here in Boston right now, that all the trains were up in Canada shipping oil, and that there wasn't enough trains for moving corn, and so corn was like $8 a bushel or something like that. Anyways, I have the price multiplier on this map set around $4.50 a bushel, and I think the fields, the yield of corn, is right around 250 bushel an acre. However, once soil management comes around, that will all change. Thankfully. Because I'm getting really sick of there not being a point for all my manure on my dairy farm. You can just throw down synthetic, you don't have to worry about pH, you don't have to worry about anything, you don't have to cultivate, you just harvest and mow, or harvest and plant, and that's all you do. I'm gonna pick up my rakes. Now, who would not want to use the Krone Forage Harvester to pick up these beautiful windrows? It'd be so easy. You just bring your Peterbilt with the haylage trailer and go to town. Making silage in no time. That's done. Before, I had to do two headlands with this massive windrower. You really only need to do one, and that's pretty sufficient for room. I'm digging how this thing looks when you lift it up. Pretty sure this mod is available anywhere. Just Google it, you'll find it. The windrower, I mean. So that's El Deno, and I think what I'm going to do is I really need to get a second pair of mowers. I'm not sure if this is... He's missing a lot of spots, but what can you do? I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my combine, because honestly, I don't really need it. We use the multi-mode to mow down our wheat, so I'm just going to take this beautiful, beautiful work of art and oh, that was sweet. American flag behind this monster. Alright, well, enough of that. I want to get a forage harvester with a pickup header. Hopefully I'll get enough. Oh. Oh my god, this thing is so cool. If you're in one of those little cars and you saw this machine coming down the road, what would you do? I should probably fold in my equipment here. So, I mean, this is a 45-foot header, and it looks small on this machine, really. Yeah, we had soybeans a lot. Don't even own that field, so. Alright, how much is this dealer gonna give us? They're gonna give us 51 grand, okay. And they're gonna give us... okay. I still don't think we have enough. I think we're gonna have to wait for our milk to come in. So we're looking for a... oh my goodness. That sucks. So we have one more little loop passing. So that means can we get a pickup header? Can we get 14,000? I get that. And then I mean, I guess I'm gonna have to sell my T9, unfortunately. Not like I really need it for anything. yet. Boss status. I've seen plenty of footage of this tractor anyways. Looks cool. Makes the 620 quad track look like a toy. Oh well. Bye bye. Alright. Let's get us Forge Harvester. Yeah. Awesome. Drum roll, please. Should really have a New Holland 990 or something, but this will do. Gotta put on my four wheel drive. Alright, I'm going to show you guys how to use Follow Me. Oh, this thing has got slow steering. This thing looks kind of goofy. We're just gonna dominate this field over here quick, because we want silage. We want silage for our cows. What can we all do with this? Not much. You can put a pipe out, and then you can unfold it. Cool. The only downside to this is it chops everything. It doesn't act as like a pickup header for like straw or grass like it did in 13. I remember in 13 you could use this pickup header to actually like pick up the straw and the grass without having to chop it. Gonna go over here and pick up one of these Peterbilts. Because we have plenty of hay. It was like 101 bales at 6,000 a bale. But we have plenty of hay. That's certainly not the concern here. Great, my driver's stuck again. What are you doing? So these trees, you can cut them all down because they're in the way, obviously, and plow up your island. Boogity boogity boogity. Here we go. Ooh, traffic. Do we have mirrors? Kinda, sorta. You can almost see. I don't know what that one's looking at. That's looking at absolutely nothing. So I'm just gonna load up my course 12 again and change my working width to what was it, like 19.5. I think that's right. So what we'll do is we'll just okay, no, that's not right. 12.19.5. What? Yeah. Load 12. Sounds cool. Then we want dynamic fill planes. I don't want them so far ahead when I'm doing all these corners. I want them to be pretty much parallel. So this is just standard in-game equipment, picking up this alfalfa. Oh boy. Why do you do that? Why do you do that? Pretty close to a full trailer. Oh crap. Whoops. So I think we just lost a bunch of silage. Or at least that whole row. Well, what can you do? I was wondering why the field paint was a rookie mistake. I'll show you guys how this, oh my god, too fast. I don't own those, bunkers yet. Because I don't really have that much, commodity coming in. So, I'm just dumping this out here. Works pretty good. And then, so we're at 'm pretty decent on the silage. So, we're about a third full. I'm gonna fix. I'm gonna get this guy going. And, turn that off. Oh my gosh, what's this guy doing? This off just because there isn't much left, and then start up that wind rower. I don't know why I turned on the lights, it's not even dark out. Well, it will be in 15 minutes, but. So we need to get this guy going. So we are field work. We're doing field 11. I'm gonna bump this down to that start corner south east. We're going north, and we want to see what that gives us. All right, good enough for me. Now we're just gonna let this guy boogie. And hopefully he doesn't catch up. So that's a humongous field of soybeans. It's like 50 hectares or something. Right along the river. It's expensive. It's like 8,000 an acre. Or 11,000, yeah. 11,000 an acre. So, when you get a chance to play on this map, I sure hope you like to farm, because there's sure a heck of a lot to farm here. There's beef, there's pig, there's cows, there's forestry, there's all kinds of sell points, there's a little bit of everything. Beautiful scenery, buyable objects, multi-fruit. You can make compost, sell compost. It's got everything. Except soil management. So here comes our monster windrower just destroying